have labelled Nigel Perrotty deranged.
It was one of the biggest manhunts in Queensland's history. Heavily armed police officers intent on tracking down Nigel Perrotty, who'd shot three of their own. The 32-year-old ambushed the officers and fired 10 times when they pulled up to investigate a neighbourhood dispute at Chermside in May 2000. Perrotty then vanished, while his victims faced a long road to recovery. 3 weeks later, the gunman's body was found in nearby bushland. He'd suffered a single gunshot wound to the head. The death classified suicide.
There hasn't been any public contact at all to indicate that there was any foul play in the death of Nigel Perrotty.
Nearly 2 years on, detectives assisted the coroner in closing the final chapter of this case, which she deemed suicide.
On the part of the family and the people that were involved in the police incident, a little bit of closure, I suppose, but to make sure that everything has been investigated thoroughly.
The inquest heard Perrotty called himself Jesse James and fantasised about killing, but friends defended him, dismissing claims he was a psychopath.
He was an honestly caring, loving bloke.
At times, Perrotty may have been caring, but he was also deranged. The court heard he bugged a feuding neighbour's house, spray-painted his dog, and threatened to shoot and cripple him.
No one will ever be sure of the exact nature of Perrotty's mental illness. Kim Scoubras, 7 News.